Service provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so today we are going to discussing about frames. Okay, so basically in HTML you'll be having frames, right? Now how do you design the frames in HTML? First we'll see how do you design the frames. First we'll see, like, what are the tags we use for designing the frames. First I'll show you. So I'll write the note. I'll write the notes for this. Basically in HTML. Okay, frames are going to be designed using the tag name called frameset. Okay, the frame is going to be designed using a frameset. Okay, okay. So frames, what are frames basically? So frames are nothing but a HTML page. So what we try to do, basically we try to create three HTML pages. Okay, I'll just show one idea how the frames looks like. Okay, suppose for example this is the HTML example I'm going to show right now to everyone, and also I'm going to interact with this HTML page. Okay, so if you see here, in this page we have three pages. They are aligned in such a way that three pages aligned on top of another page. Okay, totally how many pages you see here? Four pages. One page on top of three more pages, they are aligned. Okay, one page, three pages, they aligned on top of it. So the page on which they are aligned, it's called the top window or a top content. Okay, again I'm saying, basically what happens here, first you try to design three pages. Three web pages you have to design. Usually being a tester, we'll not design the frames, right? We'll not design the frames. Basically developers design the frames and they'll put the elements in the frames, right? But we have to understand how to design the frames and what is the concept behind it. So it helps us to understand better. Okay, again I'm saying, first you define three HTML pages, and all these three HTML pages you're going to place on another page. That page I call as a top content or a top window. On the top window you place these three HTML pages. Okay, fine. So totally you see four are there, not three, four are there. Fine. So how do I place these three HTML pages on another page? How it is possible? Yes, it is possible in HTML using a tag name called frameset. Okay, so I'm going to design this three HTML pages on a new page using a frameset. So frameset is a tag. Actually it is not required to learn, but anyway I'll just explain you how these three pages are aligned on a new page. Okay, let's see. Suppose for example, these three pages are going to be aligned on a new page using a tag called frameset. Okay, so we are going to see a tag called frameset. On frameset, on top of it, we are going to align these three pages. Let's see. So basically, frameset has columns. Okay, frame set has columns. The columns means, suppose for example, the whole page I design as 100%. The whole page I consider as 100%. So what I do basically, I'll try to put some 20% for the first frame or first page, or 30% for the second page, and remaining 50% for the third page. Right. So what we are trying to do now, on this page, we try to place three more pages by dividing the percentage. Dividing the percentage means, see here, see, if you add 20%, 30%, 50%, what is happening? These 3%, if you add, it will come to 100%. The page is 100% and we are dividing the 100% into 3 columns. Okay, we're dividing these 3 into, dividing these 3 into 3 different sections of the page. On 20%, I'll display one page. On 30%, I'll display another page. On 50%, I'll display another page. Okay. So what I'm planning to do, I'll take one page. Okay. I'll define one frame set. On the frame set, I'll divide these sections, and each and every section I'm going to call another frame. Okay. So let's see. Okay, now let's see. See, I have defined 3 frames, okay, and first frame 1 is reserved 20% of the page. Means 20% of the page, we can use it to display the frames1.html. So what I have to do first I have to create a frames1.html. Okay, then I have to call that frames1.html in the frame set. So what happens? 20% it will be displayed. Okay, then frames2.html, 30% it will be displayed. frames3.html, 50% it will be displayed. Right? So that is how it happens. If you see, in this case also, what I did here, see, I reserved 20% here for this frame. I reserved 50% for this frame. I reserved 20% for this frame or 25% for this frame. So if you add these 3 percentages, it comes to 100. Right? So when you see the source code, I'll show the source code of the top window or the top content. Let me show the top window source code, view page source. Okay, what I have written, can anybody tell me what the columns contain? What are able to see calls contain? Frame set calls contain basically 25% comma star frame set calls contain. I'm saying calls, C-O-L-S, calls refers to columns. 25% comma star comma 25%. Yeah, tell me what is star refers to. Star refers to what? Just now I told you, sum of these percentages should be 100. So what I mean to say, you display 25% space for the frame.html, you display star 50% for the frame.html, you display frame.html the 25%. Okay, so now you got it. When I open a page, what are the frames you are seeing? That is not only 3, there is one more page background on top of it where you are placing these 3 pages. Star refers to 50%. Just now already I told you 100% means 25%, 25%, 50%. The remaining star refers to 50%. Yeah, yes, fine. Now what is happening? Suppose for example, now what I said, everybody is able to understand, right? Suppose for example, when you open the page, you see the frames, those are not the frames. You see back end, in the background, there is one more page. On top of it, you are placing these 3 pages. That is the objective. First, you are able to understand this point. We'll see where are we right now. Okay, fine. Fine. So basically what is happening, whenever I open the page, by default, I am in the top window. The focus is not in these frames. Whenever I open the page, the focus is in the top window or the top content, right? I never have focus on any of these frames. So if you want to go to a frame, in Selenium WebDriver, or if you want to change the focus from the top window to a frame, we have to use a method. It's not easy to just go switch the focus from the top window to the frame. Again, I'm saying whenever I open the page, the focus is on the top window. Okay. And if you want to go and perform any action in the frames, first you have to switch to that frame. Okay. So let's write down the code. Suppose, for example, here, I write down the text notes for this. Whenever we open the page which has frames, the focus is on the top window. Okay. Then also the top window, how you can see, basically I say top window, fine, but how can I see, or how many frames are available? How do I see? Is it possible to see the frames? Yes, we can see the frames. We can see the top window, whether where are you are in the top window, or you are in a frame one, or you are in a frame two or frame three, we can see. I'll show you that one second. So whenever you open the page which has frames, the focus is on the top window. Okay. If you want to switch from top window to a frame, we have to use the driver dot Okay, so what are the methods I have to use to switch from a top window to a frame? When I open the page, my focus is on the top window by default. I don't need to do anything. But if I want to go to a particular frame, suppose for example, I want to go to a particular frame called frame one. Here, I want to go to this frame and I want to enter the text. It is not possible to enter the text here without switching to the frame. First, we have to switch to the frame. Then only we can enter the text. So how do I switch to frame? I require a frame name, or else I require a index. Those two points I require. Okay, those two points I require. So what I do first, suppose for example, in Selenium WebDriver, the indexing starts from the left hand side, and also index starts from 0. So 0 refers to frame 1. Frame 2 refers to index 1. Frame 3 refers to index 2. Okay, so when I'm in the top window, if you want to switch to a particular frame, I use a method called driver.switch2.frame. See, what is the method I have to use? Driver.switch2.frame. I can use index. This is frame. I can use index, or else I can use frame name. Okay, so first I'll write the code, then I'll explain you how we can find out where are we right now. First